Yo, what's up everybody? This is your friendly neighborhood Unpunk, bringing you a tutorial here today that's going to be covering the Voyage of Despair Easter egg in its entirety, each of the steps, how you get through them, some cheat sheets I made for certain steps like the clock step and the planet step, as well as how the boss fight works and how to beat it. This is not a very difficult boss fight if you have the correct setup, and I'll share with you a little cheat to make it a little quicker of a certain gun to use, as well as you're going to need to make sure you know how to do the pack-a-punch. Build the shield will be recommended, and how to build slash collect and upgrade the Kraken. I will leave links down in the description for all those steps, and well, let's get right into it. The first step, there is going to be these different symbols around the map, which will be in all the areas that I will shoot. Some of them won't show up in this particular game. And there is going to be a clock that corresponds to it. Each clock is going to have a set time on it that changes once you have done the pack-a-punch, which is the first step of the Easter egg. So as you can see, there are symbols, either a triangle that is a normal looking triangle pointing up, a triangle pointing downwards or flipped over, a triangle downwards slash flipped over with a line through it, or a triangle that's normal with a line through the top. Those are your four symbols. You just need to make sure you keep track of which one is which and which time is showing on that corresponding clock, which all will be shown right here, all six possible locations. If you don't see the symbol, obviously it's not in that game, but that's where the symbol will spawn. The next part of this is you're going to have to go to both the bridge and the back of the ship and enter in these codes you get, which are times on the corresponding dials. So you'll see in just a second that there are four dials in the front bridge that all can be set to a certain time, as well as four dials in the back part of the ship, two being by the Sentinel artifact where you first activate it, and two being underneath in the boiler slash engine room area. The back of the boat is going to be the hour, whereas the front of the boat is going to correspond to the minute. Basically, how this is going to work is each one is labeled with one of the symbols that you had seen earlier next to the clocks. Each one of these little dials will be able to go a certain number of turns to the left and a certain number of turns to the right. Every way that I look is the way to look at it. So this last one on the far left, you're going to want to look at opposite to the rest, so that way you can do this step correctly each time. When you're looking at this, the front is obviously going to correspond to the minutes, and the back is going to correspond to the hours. That's a good reference to keep. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pop up on screen now a little cheat sheet of the different positions it can be in and how the time works on the clock. When you get to the step, you can use this as a good reference. I have this on my Twitter as well. You can see that the top will obviously stand for the 12 o'clock position or zero. And then as you go to each direction, it goes in increments of 5 minutes or 1 hour or negative increments of 5 minutes. So to the left, we'll go to 55, 50, and etc. And right, we'll go to 5, 10, 15, etc. Now, to make this step easy, all you gotta do is be able to read a clock and look for symbols. It's not a very difficult step, but it is overcomplicated quite often, and knowing the position you need to look at as well as put it in makes it so much easier. So seeing that visual representation should help a lot of you guys, making this step definitely a lot easier. Now, as you see, I'm back at the top poop deck. You can see that there is the red one there, which corresponds clearly to the red one that is up front. And how these work is the right and then the second from the left, if you're looking at them on the bridge, will relate to the two ones in the engine room. Whereas if you are on the top poop deck, it will relate to the second from the right, and the far left is what these two will correspond to. Obviously, again, if you are in the back of the boat, they all need to be set to the correct hour position. So for example, if you had 250, you're gonna need to turn the one in the back to the red to the right two times, and the front poop deck needs to turn to the left two times. I know it can be a little confusing looking, but we're gonna go downstairs, check out the last two ones, I'll explain what they connect to, and then we'll be good on this step. When heading down here, you can obviously go right past the Odin statue, and you will see that there is four total dials. two will be broken beyond belief, and only two will be interactable. I don't recall which one goes to which, but I do believe the right one corresponds to the left, the second from the left, and the left one corresponds to the far right in the bridge. They're a little bit backwards, so just mess with them, have someone at the bridge, and have someone back here, and you'll get this step done in no time. Next up, what you gotta do is go around and look around the map for these plugs you will see here. There's six total spawns, and all you have to do is look in the top left corner here of this guide to see which area they are if you're having a hard time finding them. As you can see, that one has a magma slash fire element pouring out of it, and basically what's gonna happen is four of these plugs will have an element pouring out of it. This one has ice, for example, you'll see in just a second, and what you need to do is you need to kill the corresponding elemental zombie next to it. I would recommend that when you guys get done with the clock step, go around and look at all six locations or until you find your four elements and write them down or make sure you keep track, because you're gonna need to know that for the step after this or to complete this step. When you go ahead and complete this step, or how you complete this step rather, is you need to take the corresponding elemental zombie to the corresponding plug with that element and just kill it near it. Doesn't need to be right on top, but just take it to pretty close area and you'll be able to kill it, and it will make a circle appear on the floor. Upon making that circle appear on the floor, you're going to need to then proceed to the next round. Otherwise, you cannot charge another plug, and you can notice if you stay in the same round, all the other plugs will no longer have an elemental spark. It does not randomize by round, it will always be the set way per game, so don't worry about losing track of them. So I'd recommend getting them all figured out in one round, and then start charging as you get an elemental zombie. Now, for the next step, once you charge it, you're going to need to activate a ritual in a set order. It needs to be in this order, so it has to be with the acid one first. So whatever one where you charge the plug with an acid zombie, that's the first ritual you need to start. The second needs to be the ice ritual, followed by the electric, and finishing it off with the fire. If you do not do it in that order, it will require you to redo all four of them. Now here you can see that I got an electric zombie in the lower grand staircase, and I bring it up to the top where it will end up charging. It's very easy to do. This is not a difficult step, but you just gotta make sure you're coordinating with your team and not killing elemental zombies unless you already have the element of that plug charged and ready to go. This will take four rounds, so I recommend getting here as quick as you possibly can by getting that clock step done very quickly, so that way you can get these charges and then get your gun set up and get going into the rituals. As you can see, that's what the symbol will look like. It will never disappear, and you can go as many rounds as you need. We are right here at the acid ritual in our particular game. You get all players on top and hold square by all players, and you will get trapped in a small area. There's four different areas. This one on the poop deck, there is one in the cargo hold, the hardest in my opinion. There is one on top of the boat deck on the very top of the boat, and then there is one in the boiler room, which is also pretty tough. I recommend having at minimal one person with the Kraken or the pack-a-punched, I don't remember what the rocket launcher is called, but the pack-a-punched rocket launcher. That will absolutely destroy bosses, both of the types of zombie bosses, the big red hammer guys, the stokers, as well as the blight fathers will spawn in during these steps, except for the fourth and final one. That one will only spawn a lot of stokers. They are not extremely hard, but make sure again you have some Hades, or you have at least one Kraken or one Pack-a-Punch rocket launcher to make sure you can get through this step. Also to note, you go in max ammo once you complete the first ritual, or rather, it's there the entire time. You can see it in the background here. It's waiting there for you. You can grab that at any time, but I recommend waiting till you're done with the ritual so you can get a full max ammo for the second. And then once you get into the third, you'll have another max ammo waiting for you, and the fourth will obviously not have one either. So phase one and three have a max ammo waiting for you, two and four do not. Again, make sure you charge these in the correct order, which is acid, ice, electric, fire, and you won't have a very hard time. We waited a few rounds from when we charged our little circles and got all of our circles out, so that way we could get at least one player with the Kraken. The homoculus are absolutely amazing for this step, and again, that rocket launcher pack punched is ungodly good. It also is the best weapon to bring into the boss fight, as it can almost one-shot each phase of the boss, which I'll explain at the end of the video. Now, again, this step is not extremely hard, but you are tight quarters, so you need to make sure that you are set up and have your team ready to go. I'd recommend some perks as well as aftertaste activated. That's going to make this a lot easier. Those homunculus really are going to kick butt. Now, the second one is particularly difficult because the water will start to raise when you are doing this ritual. So what you need to do is you need to make sure that you stay at the front here. It is the easiest spot to hold down. You get all players looking one of three directions and have the person with the Kraken covering and helping with all the others. Use all your equipment you have, whether it's the Wraith Fires or Acid Grenades or whatever you have, or even the Homunculus if you have it. Use your specialist, because that's going to really help during this phase of the fight. Now, again, once you defeat all the zombies and you defeat the multiple Blightfathers, there is 2 to 3 that will spawn in each phase. You will complete it and be able to pick up the artifact once again. As soon as you are done, you go on to the next ritual and you will be good to go to the next step of the Easter egg. This next step is pretty easy, but you are going to need the acid version of the Kraken. So if you don't know how to get that, make sure to check my description on how to do that. There's a video down there in the description. Next, you want to make your way to the turbine room. You're going to see these blue pipes have a mist or water coming out them. You just need to shoot them just right to where they start making a kind of ice looking effect off them. Again, you need that upgraded acid version of the Kraken to be able to do this step, so you can't proceed without it. There's going to be a total of 9 different blue pipes you need to shoot. They are a little tricky to get, so make sure you have enough ammo if you are doing this for your first time, because it's going to take a couple of shots most likely to get it to go. There are some tricky locations, so I'm going to show them all off here. This one's kind of hidden. Above this one, if you look straight up, there is one which I'll show at the very end, but that one gave me the hardest time to find. It was just such a little tricky one, just hiding right up in the roof. There's also 2 right here in the middle that can be a little bit tricky, as you see. And once you're completed with this, the room will start to flood, and you need to make sure that you end the round after the room is completely flooded, or it might glitch out your teleporter, or your pack-a-punch rather, just a little tiny bit. But it won't be game-breaking, just a little bit annoying. So once you get this last one, you'll see that room starting to flood. Make sure that you end the round, not like I just did, but make sure you start the round once this whole entire bottom room is flooded. What's going to happen is when you skip from the round you got the room flooding to the next round, you'll be able to get the Pack-a-Punch only down there in the water, and you just need to put the artifact in the Pack-a-Punch, and it will come out a few seconds later, and it will be purple and Pack-a-Punched, and you'll be ready to go. That is not a very hard step, of course, but you need that Kraken and you need the acid upgrade. I recommend not pack-a-punching it at the first and just getting the acid one for 3,000 points instead of having to spend 6,000. Now, this next step is pretty easy to start, but can be very, very complicated. And this is the planet or the orb step, whatever you want to call it. So there is a total of 9 planets that are going to spawn in around the map when you hit these different symbols. They look like this. I'm going to show off every single location here with the exclusion of the bridge, as I missed recording that. So I do apologize, that won't be in here, but I will have a cheat sheet that tells you where it is. So just go look in it. It's pretty easy to find, and Reddit also has its locations all on there. You just need to go ahead and activate all of these. This one particularly, you have to lay all the way flat to pick up, and it's a little bit weird. But once you get all these spawned in, you'll see that there is different planets in the sky. As you see on screen now, these are the different planets by name. I color coordinated this little guide so that way you guys can see what the color of the planet will look like in the sky, because it's hard to tell some of their positions. Now, this next step is going to require you to go down into the little room past the mail room in the cargo hold, that cargo hold area, and you're going to be able to see this as you see on screen, minus my little notes on there. And it's going to, once you hold square, start a wave of zombies spawning at you. So make sure you have a player protecting you and you watch all of these little things flash. Basically, how it works is that little bit will flash and it will show you which planet is first and the order you need to shoot the planets out of the sky in. I'm going to continue to show you the locations here for the symbols while we explain this part of it, this next part, which obviously is shooting down each of the planets. As you shoot a planet down, you need to make sure a player is near or close by one of the symbols that corresponds to that planet you just shot. So for example, if you're in the Millionaire Suite, you need to shoot the corresponding planet that will be for the Millionaire Suite. So you're gonna have to probably have one player outside able to see the planets and one player with an upgraded Kraken, probably to the ice element, I would recommend, all the way pack-a-punched and ice upgraded, so that way you can fight off all the zombies and bosses that will spawn. After you do the fifth one, you will get a max ammo as well as a Blight Father, so make sure you guys are ready for that one. The one you saw just right there at the forecastle is for the sun specifically and will always be your last planet to do. So don't worry, you don't have to get the sun right off the bat. This is the last symbol I show here, and then I'll show you what the little planet step looks like. It's very, very fast when you activate it, so you have to make sure you have a good eye or can record it and watch it back real quick, but you don't have a lot of time to watch it back. So in that order, you see that it goes and then you're done. I'll go a little slower. So it went over to the Neptune, or not Neptune. Yeah, I went to, I don't remember the names of all the planets off the top of my head. But nonetheless, when you go ahead and do this, you can see that it does go. This is at half speed. So it's easy at half speed, but it's much harder at normal. As soon as you get your code and you figure it all out, what you gotta do is just go ahead and shoot down the planets. As you can see right here, Neptune is in the water, so I go ahead and shoot the Neptune planet. It will make it go up into the sky, and it will appear near this symbol. So again, you need to make sure you are ready before you shoot the planet, and have a specialist or a Kraken or something along those lines ready to go. And then you just have to hold square and collect the planet like you just saw there. It's a pretty simple minded step, but it is very, very hard to do, especially getting the correct order can be very hard. If you fail and shoot the wrong planet or run out of time before you collect that planet, you're gonna have to wait till the next round and restart all planets. So make sure you're very, very careful during this step and you're looking at that picture I have as a reference for both the colors of the planets in the sky as well as how close they are to the sun and what symbol they correlate to. If you guys can get past this step, you are almost to the boss fight and you're just about ready to go and get the Easter egg complete. The boss fight can be very easy, but a little overwhelming. So make sure you guys follow my steps at the end here so that way you can see exactly what's set up to bring. When you guys get 8 out of the 9 planets, you will see that the sun is always the last one. Now, before you activate or shoot down the sun, you won't be able to pick it up just normally, so make sure to get all players with a Kraken in your game. If you do not have a Kraken, this step is going to be so, so hard, or the rocket launcher will work as a substitute. Make sure they have a Pack-a-Punch Kraken or a Pack-a-Punch rocket launcher, or this step's going to be absolutely insane to do and complete, because you have to shoot different ice blocks on either the right or the left path. We're going to take the right path in this and we end up failing. Luckily, you can just restart this the next round, so it's not extremely crazy if you mess up. But once you've shot that last star down, you're on a timer to go and activate it. So you want to activate it, and then you have to shoot these little ice blocks around the map. So they're going to be blocking your path. You're going to want to have specials or homunculus ready to go and start throwing and using those. Whereas the other players that are not interacting with the ice or trying to shoot it to destroy it are obviously shooting it. So you have to go through quite a few different blocks of ice. They're very, very powerful. They have a lot of damage. They take a lot of damage rather. So make sure you guys continually keep unloading on them. I would say at least 2/3 of your characters need to have that Kraken or the rocket launcher to be able to do it, because you can see this destroys it pretty quick, but nonetheless it still takes a lot of time and you are time locked as well as dealing with zombies in this step, so it can be very, very tricky. So keep practicing it until you get it down. If you fail, don't worry, you can do it again the next round. You just gotta wait and go ahead and go again. As you can see, I have Death Wish on, so that saves me a lot in this, because you get a lot of Stokers, you get a lot of Blightfathers towards the end, you get a lot of boss zombies and zombies, so make sure you're using those monkeys and your weapons to maximum efficiency and working very well with your team. You'll see at the end here, I fail it, but once you complete it, it's going to do the white flash on your screen again, as per usual for these kind of steps. And you'll have a symbol appear at the very back a part of the poop deck where the max ammo spawns for the ritual you did earlier on the poop deck. As you can see, if a player goes down, you will 100% fail this. You cannot have a player go down because you will not have enough firepower to be able to do it. Your screen starts to freeze if you fail, so if you're getting too close, you might as well just save your ammo and try it again the next round. Once you complete this, again, you will have one last ritual to activate the boss fight, and you'll be ready to go on to the boss. Once you get into the boss and teleport here, you will see a tree you need to swim up to, and we'll activate a little bit of a cutscene kind of like animation here, which is something that they recently added to the Black Ops 4 style of maps, allowing you to have cutscenes before and after boss fights, which is abnormal. You normally just get one at the end, and all cutscenes are rendered in game, so there's no way of data mining them, which is really, really fantastic on Treyarch's part. But after you see this little cinematic here, there's going to be a big cube of ice that comes out of the ground, and you start to fight a big floating eyeball. Now, I'm not going to leave you much on this because I don't want to waste your time in this guide just watching the boss fight. If you guys want to see how the boss fight works in all of the phases, check out my boss fight full video on my channel. It has all of the commentary so you guys can hear how we worked as a team and how everything works. But basically, you just got to go through 5 phases of it. The first 2 phases, you do not need to hurt the boss. You just need to survive and make sure you stay away from the zombies, which can be pretty easy. And then the 3rd, 4th, and 5th, you do need to attack him. Again, if you're having any troubles with the boss fight, just check out my video I have on my channel. It shows us all having ice krakens, which is an absolute must. And I would have one player also have the Pack-a-Punch rocket launcher. I didn't do this in my particular game that we beat this, but I heard that if you use that on the 3rd, 4th, and 5th stage, where you have to damage the boss, the floating eye, it will one-shot the boss in each of those phases, allowing you to basically cheese it. I could be wrong and it could have been patched with today's update, so if it doesn't work out, let me know in the comments, and if it does, also let me know in the comments. One important thing to note is that during the final stage, the 5th ritual, which will be back here on the poop deck, when the boss is doing a loud hissing, screeching kind of noise, you need to make sure everybody starts focusing on the boss. So throw your homunculuses, which I recommend every single player has when they're going to this boss fight, or at least 2 or 3, and throw your homunculus and start unloading into the boss. If you don't do that, you are most likely going to die, because he will wipe the entire team out. He will insta-kill everybody if he can reach full power on his charge. The characters will start to say something along the lines of, "He is charging up, don't let him get full charge," something along those lines. So make sure when you hear that, or you see that loud noise, or hear that loud noise rather, because you can't see noises with your eyes, that would be crazy. But if you could, then GG to you. But nonetheless, make sure you guys are shooting him until he does a little, basically, stutter slash little stun effect, and then keep hitting him. This boss fight will be over as soon as he, like, sooner than you know. It's a really easy boss fight as long as you know how to do it, which again is just 5 different phases of surviving. 3 of them you have to shoot him. And make sure to check the video if you guys are having any more trouble with it. I'm sure you guys have probably seen the boss fight plenty of times, so I don't want to waste too much of your time on that. This is gonna be your full Easter egg guide. I hope this helped you guys complete the Voyage of Despair Easter egg. As of the time of me completing this a few days ago, 4 players would almost always crash before the end of the Easter egg or during the boss fight. So I'd recommend doing this solo, 2 or 3 players, to make it easier for yourself and almost guarantee no crash. The 2 times I did it with 3 players, we had no issues with crash. I don't know if today's patch update actually fixed it or not, but I would definitely recommend doing it with less than 4 players, as that crash will really waste your time if you have to redo it, and it can be very, very frustrating. Again, this has been your friendly neighbor Dumpunk, bringing you a Voyage of Despair guide. Down in the description, there will be links to anything you need to know that is not covered in this guide. So if you're having any trouble with anything else or don't know how to do a step, there will be guides down below to help guide you through that as well as the rest of this video. I hope you guys did enjoy. Drop a like if you did. Make sure to subscribe if you're new. Leave a comment down below, and we'll see you soon. Peace.